Guillermo Corral from Sosa Ingredients, and I'm here today to present you the revolution and evolution of the mousse. With the finality to obtain the maximum flavor and taste, reduce maximum as possible the quantity of fats and sugar inside the mousse and the egg yolk, all these elements that can disturb in the flavors. We have classified that in three evolutions. The first one is evolution number one, evolution number two, and the vegan. When you will see step by step that in all of them we are taking out these elements that can disturb in the flavor for the finality to obtain the maximum flavor. In case of mousse evolution, we have made the raspberry mousse. We can see how through the visual and organoleptic parameters, the color gets more intensity, the texture becomes lighter, and in the end we have more intensity of flavor. As well through the techniques parameters, we can see how the fruit contents increases 20%, the fat contents becomes 0%, the flavor sensation increases 40%, and the sweetness decreases from 40 to 30%. We are going to make the more raspberry mousse evolution one, and we are going to show you the ingredients we are going to use to replace the original ones in a classical mousse. We are going to start talking about the guar gum. Guar gum is the thickener that is going to help us in order to get a nice stability in between the fat and water molecule. Albu whip, it's a protein coming from the white egg that help us in order to make a meringue starting from a fruit purée, and we can replace part of the cream for this meringue in order to get the same consistency. Inulin, it's a fibrous, as it used as a bulking agent as well, that help us in order to take out part of the cream and replace for inulin to get the same fat effect. In the end, we're going to use bovine gelatin for the gel effect. We can mix already the fruit puree with the albu whip. the case of the nuts mousse, we have made a pistachio mousse. And we can see how through the visual and organoleptic parameters, we have increased the intensity of the color, we have a lighter texture, and we have more intensity of flavor as well. The technical parameters, we can see how we increase the amount of nuts, more than 15%. The containing fat, it means the cream, goes from 25% till 0%. The flavor filling increases more than 18%, and in the end the sweetness decreases from 50% to 40%. It's important to remember that the parameters of the flavor sensation and the sweetness, it's a subjective values. Keep controlling the temperature. At this point, we need to be up 30 in order to avoid that the gelatin sets quick. Pour everything in a piping bag and it's ready to fill our molds. In the case of the chocolate mousse, we can see how through the visual and organoleptic parameters, we have increased the intensity of the color, we have more creaminess and more intensity of flavor as well. About the technical parameters, we can see how we increase the amount of chocolate 10%, we have less cream that goes from 30 to 0%, the flavor filling goes from 50 to 70%, and in the end, the sweetness decreases from 45 to 38%. We have to remember that the flavor filling and the sweetness, they are subjective values. To do our vegan chocolate mousse, we are going to use these three texturizings. Let me introduce you the vegan mousse gelatin that was created
mainly to do vegan mousse. It's a mix of starch and it contains a kind of agar-agar that sets at low temperature. So in that way, we can introduce in a mousse and have a progressive gelification. At the same time, we're going to combine with potato whip. It's a protein coming from the potato and it has the capacity to whip, so we can make a water meringue. In the end, we are going to use as well the xanthan gum. It's a thickener that has as well emulsion capacity, so we can set the fat and water part. Let's mix before part of the water with the potato whip. And we are going to blend this during a minute. That's important in order to avoid any lump. Put everything in the KitchenAid and we can start whipping it. Aside, we are going to pour part of the water as well in a saucepan with the vegan mousse gelatin. That's important to mix always at cold temperature and bring up to a boil in order to activate. You will see how it changes and it turns in a lighter cream when it starts boiling. We can mix the sides, the sugar and the xanthan gum, and we are going to add this in our meringue. Slowly, step by step, in order to melt it proper. Keep whipping for a couple of minutes until we get a nice and stable meringue. Aside, we are going to melt the chocolate at 45 degrees. And we pour inside a little bit sunflower oil in order to get a little bit more fluidity. We pour everything in a jar and we are going to blend at the same time while we emulsify with our water with the vegetal jelly. Pour everything in a bowl and we stir gently. It's very important to work this technique between 40 to 50 degrees in order to avoid that the gelatin starts setting. We start adding part of the meringue and we stir gently until it's completely combined. We can already add the remaining meringue and we keep stirring until we have a regular base and our mousse, it will be done. Keep controlling the temperature. At this point, we need to be up 30 in order to avoid that the gelatin sets quick. Pour everything in a piping bag and it's ready to fill our molds.